بسم الله الحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We will continue the rules of Nun Sakina and Tanween, and today we will talk about Idgham. The literal meaning of Idgham is to merge, to meet, and in Tajweed rules, Idgham only happens when two letters meet with each other. And also remember, the term Idgham is not only for Nun Sakina and Tanween. Rather, we have different types of idgham that inshallah we will discuss in our future classes. But there is one term that we will keep using in all types of idgham, and that is idgham kamil and idgham naqis. And these two terms are used in every kind of idgham. So we will discuss these terms in details. However, as today we are discussing the rules of Nun Sakina and Tanween, so today our discussion of idgham will be in reference to Nun Sakina and Tanween. And we will discuss all the types of idgham that happens in Nun Sakina and Tanween, including idgham kamil and idgham naqis. And we will try to understand these terms by their common definition and their specific definition in regards to Nun Sakina and Tanween. Idgham is to merge, and it can be defined as the insertion of one thing into another. When it comes to the rules of Nun Sakina and Tanween, idgham is the merging of a sakin nun into a vowel letter, either completely or incompletely. So they become one letter of the second type. Whenever Nun Sakina or Tanween is followed by Yarumalun letters, letter Ya, letter Ra, letter Mim, letter Lam, letter Waw, or letter Nun, the sakin letter Nun or the sakin letter Nun hidden in Tanween either completely or incompletely merge into one of these letters. And we can see some examples right here. Mim in letter Nun is completely merged into this meme, and you cannot hear the sound of this Nun. I'm not saying min-ma-in, I'm saying mim-ma-in. So letter Nun is completely merged into this meme. We hold the gunna for some time, and this is how we recite it. Mim-ma-in. In the next example, Nun Sakina will be merged into letter Ra. And when I will be reciting this, you will not hear letter Nun at all. I will recite it like this. Mirrizqin. In the next example, Nun Sakina is followed by letter Nun, which is also one of the Yarmalun letters. So we will merge letter Nun and we will recite this word like this. Min Nutfatin. We will merge letter Nun and we will hold the gunna for some time and we will recite it like this. Min nutfatin. Next example, Tanween is followed by letter Lam, and letter Lam is also one of the letters of Yarmalun. We will merge the sakin letter hidden in Tanween in letter Lam and recite this word like this. Juadullakum. In the next example, Tanween is followed by letter Waw, which is one of the letters of Yarmalun. So we will merge letter Nun with letter Waw. We will hold the gunna and we will recite it like this. In the next example, you can see letter Nun Sakina is followed by letter Ya, which is one of the letters of Yarmalun letters. So we will merge letter Nun with letter Ya. We will hold the gunna for some time and we will recite it like this. Man ya'amal. We will not say man ya'amal because then I am not merging letter Nun into letter Ya. Rather, I am giving letter Nun clearly with idhar. So this is not how you merge. This is not how you do idgham. You will merge letter Nun with letter Ya and you will hold the gunna for some time and you will recite it like this. May ya'amal. Idgham of Nun Sakina and Tanween cannot occur in one word. It can only happen between two separate words. And you can also see in all these examples that all of them are two separate words. And I will do idgham only when I am continuously reciting. Let's take this example. If I'm only reciting until min And if I don't want to continue, so then I will give letter known clearly. But when I want to continue and want to recite both these words together, in that case, I will be doing idgham. When two letters will meet, only when noon sakina is followed by your maloon letter, in that case, idgham will happen. So idgham of noon sakina and tanween cannot happen in one word. It can only occur between two separate words. But in the Quran, there are four words that have the conditions of idgham of noon sakina in one word, but we do not do idgham in them. We read them with idhar just to avoid the confusion in the meaning of those words. Those four words are dunya, sinwanun, pinwanun, bunyanan. So in all these examples, you will not do idgham. Although you can see the conditions of idgham, where in this example, you can see noon sakina is followed by letter ya, which is one of the yarmaloon letters. Letter noon sakina is followed by letter waw, which is one of the yarmaloon letters. Again, letter noon sakina is followed by letter waw. Letter noon sakina here is followed by letter ya. Although you see the conditions of idgham in all these examples, but you don't do idgham, rather you do idhar and you read noon sakina clearly in all these places. In the Uthmani script, when idgham is happening, noon sakina does not have any sakin or jazm sign on it, and tanween is written slightly different than idhar, because in case of idhar, as you can see here, the two parallel lines are aligned with each other in Fathatain and Kasratain, and Dhammatain is written like this. But in Uthmani script, in case of idgham, two parallel lines are one after another in case of Fathatain and Kasratain, and the shape of Dhammatain is different, and it is like this in case of idgham. So in short, whenever noon sakina or tanween is followed by your maloon letters, we do idgham. We merge noon sakina into the vowel letter coming after it. And idgham of noon sakina cannot occur in one word. It can only occur between two separate words. Idgham of noon sakina and tanween can be divided into two sets of categories, which are further divided into two types. The first one is idgham in regards to gunna, and the second one is idgham in regards to merging. So the first type, when idgham is divided in regards to gunna, can be further divided into idgham with gunna and idgham without gunna. When noon sakina or tanween followed by your maloon letters, we divide your maloon letters into two categories when we are dividing idgham of noon sakina in regards to gunna. So the first one is yanmu letters. When noon sakina or tanween is followed by yanmu letters, letter ya, letter noon, letter meem, or letter waw, in these four letters, which are the subgroup of your maloon letters, we merge the sound of sakin letter noon along with the gunna or the nasal sound. And when noon sakina or tanween is followed by letter ra or letter lam, we merge them without the nasal sound, without the gunna. Inshallah, we will see some examples shortly, and you will find it more easy to understand with the examples. The other way we can divide idgham is in regards to merging. So when your maloon letters are divided in regards to merging, there are two types, either complete merging or incomplete merging. As I told you earlier, that this concept of complete merging and incomplete merging, this term we will use in every kind of idgham. Whenever idgham will happen, we will discuss whether this idgham is complete merging or incomplete merging. So let's talk about the general definition first, and then we will discuss complete merging and incomplete merging in regards to gunna. Whenever idgham is happening, it is either complete merging, idgham kamil, or incomplete merging, idgham naqis. In case of complete merging, when a sakin letter is followed by a vowel letter, the sakin letter completely merges into the vowel letter and nothing will be left behind from the sakin letter, not even one characteristic. And incomplete merging is the first letter will not completely merge into the second letter. The attribute or the characteristic of the first letter will remain behind. And that's why that merging will not be a complete merging, rather that will be an incomplete merging. So when you're talking about idgham kamil and idgham naqis, in regards to noon sakina and tanween, we divide your maloon letters into two categories. The first one is letter ra, letter meem, letter lam, and letter noon. When noon sakina or tanween are followed by these four letters, the noon sakina will completely merge into these letters. But if they are followed by letter ya or letter waw, the noon sakina will incompletely merge into these two letters, and there will be an attribute of sakin letter known which will remain behind. We will see the examples shortly, and inshallah that will make it more clear to you. So first we see when idgham happens in regards to gunna or the nasal sound. So when noon sakina or tanween is followed by yanmu letters, which is a subgroup of your maloon letters, we will merge the sound along with the nasal sound, and we will hold the gunna for some time, and we will see these examples now. So you can see tanween is followed by letter waw. So when I have to merge noon sakina hidden in tanween, I will not say it like this. Because at this time, I did not merge with the gunna. I said nawwa. In fact, I should be saying nawwa. I will merge letter noon sakina hidden in tanween with waw, with the nasal sound. I will hold the gunna for some time and I will recite it like this. In the next example, we see meem-ma-in. I am merging letter noon with letter meem, and you can hear the gunna. So this idgham is happening with the gunna or the nasal sound. In the next example, we see may-ya-amal. So when I'm merging letter noon with letter ya, I did not say may-ya-amal, because now I'm merging without the gunna. But when yanmu letters are coming after noon sakina or tanween, we do the merging along with the gunna. I will merge letter noon with letter ya with the nasal sound. I will hold the nasal sound for some time and I will say may-ya-amal. And if you take the example of min nutfatin, it's not written here. The word is min and then nutfatin. So I'm merging letter noon followed by another letter noon. And you can hear the gunna. I will hold the gunna for some time and I will recite it like this. Min nutfatin. And if we move on to this, this is idgham of noon sakina and tanween without gunna. When noon sakina or tanween is followed by letter lam or letter ra, we completely merge the sakin letter noon into ra or lam, and we will not hear any gunna or nasal sound. So this will be without gunna or bighair gunna. And we will recite it like this. Mir rizqin. You cannot hear the gunna. I did not say mir rizqin. Now I'm giving gunna. So, but in this case, you will join letter meem with letter ra, and you will not hear any gunna, any oral part where my tongue is touching the roof of the mouth. You will not hear anything from letter noon. I will join letter meem with letter ra, and I will recite it like this. Mir rizqin. In this example, you can see juadullakum. Don sakina, which is hidden in tanween, I will join it with letter lam, and there will be no sound of gunna, and I should not be reciting it like this. Juadullakum. Because now I'm stretching letter lam, I'm giving gunna, which is wrong. I will join letter dal with letter lam, I will not give any gunna, and I will not stretch letter lam. And I will recite it like this. Juadullakum. In the next example, you can see tanween is followed by letter lam. And we will recite it like this. رجوما للشياطين. And you will not hear any sound of غنّة. So in short, when نون ساكنة or تنوين are followed by ينمو letters, we do إدغام with غنّة, and this is called إدغام بغنّة, and you will hear the nasal sound. We will hold the غنّة for some time. But if letter نون ساكنة or تنوين followed by letter را or letter لام, we will merge letter نون ساكنة into the following letter without غنّة or nasal sound. Now we will see the idgham of noon sakina and tanween in regards to merging. So in regards to merging, your maloon letters are divided into two categories. The first one is letter meem, letter noon, letter lam, and letter ra. When noon sakina or tanween are followed by these four letters, we completely merge noon sakina or noon sakina hidden in tanween into these letters, and there is nothing left of the sakin letter noon. Any gunna that you hear is from the next letter, and that's the sifa or the characteristic of the next letter. We will see from these example, the word is min nutfatin. The sakin letter noon will be completely merged into the next letter noon, and there is nothing left from this noon. The oral part where your tip of the tongue is touching the roof of the mouth is gone, and even the sifa of gunna is gone. And when you hear the gunna in this example, the gunna is coming from the second letter, and we will recite it like this. Min nutfatin. So the gunna that you hear is from the second letter noon, and the first letter noon is completely merged into the second letter noon. In this example, if you see mim, in the first sakin letter noon is completely merged into letter meem, and the gunna that you hear is the characteristic of letter meem and not from letter noon. Letter noon is completely merged into letter meem, and nothing is left from letter noon. And this is idgham kamil. Noon sakina is completely merged into noon here and into meem here. So this is complete merging. Let's see into these example. When noon sakina is followed by letter ra, noon sakina is completely merged and you don't hear anything from the noon sakina, and we recite it like this. Mir rizqin. You don't hear any gunna. You don't even hear the makhraj of letter noon. We don't say min rizqin. We say mir rizqin. Meem is joined with letter ra, and this is complete merging of letter noon into letter ra. In this example, if we see juadul lakum, noon sakina hidden in tanween is completely merged into letter lam. Nothing is left from letter noon sakina, and this is called complete merging. Letter noon sakina hidden in tanween has completely merged into letter lam. And in Uthmani script, whenever complete merging is happening, you will find shatta on letter meem, letter noon, letter lam, and letter ra, just to tell you that the sakin letter noon has completely merged into the following vowel letter. And in case of noon and meem, the gunna is from the following letter, not from the sakin letter noon. And you will hold the gunna for some time, and you will recite these examples like this. Min nutfatin. Mimma'in, mirrizqin, juadul lakum. And this is complete merging of noon sakina into these letters, letter meem, noon, lam, and ra. And this is also called idgham kamil. Let's talk about incomplete merging in regards to noon sakina and tanween. Whenever noon sakina or tanween is followed by letter waw or letter ya, the oral part of the noon sakina will disappear, which is the tip of the tongue touching the roof of the mouth. But one of the characteristic of letter noon sakina, which is gunna, will left behind, and that gunna will be merged with these two letters when idgham of noon sakina is happening. And we call this merging an incomplete merging because the characteristic of noon sakina is left behind. And we will try to understand this in these examples. Noon sakina here is followed by letter ya, and we will recite it like this. May ya'amal. The gunna is not the characteristic of letter ya, and we are not even reciting it like this. May ya'amal. The way we need to recite it is like this. May ya'mal. Now you can hear the gunna. Gunna is the characteristic of this letter noon. And because the characteristic of this letter is left behind, that's why this merging is not complete and the merging is incomplete. And we will hold the gunna for some time and we will recite it like this. May ya'mal. And this is incomplete merging or idgham naqis. In the next example, we see tanween is followed by letter waw. Letter waw does not have the characteristic of gunna. Gunna is only the characteristic of letter noon or meem. So in this case, if I want to recite, the correct way of recitation is lawwala. So now you can hear the gunna. The gunna is the characteristic of the hidden noon sakina, which we will merge with the letter waw. So the letter noon sakina is not completely gone. Rather, the characteristic of gunna is left behind. That's why this idgham is not complete merging. And this idgham is an incomplete merging. This idgham is idgham naqis. We will not recite it like this, lawwala, because now I'm not giving the gunna of noon sakina. Rather, I should be giving the gunna, holding it for some time and reciting it like this, lawwala. So in case of yarmaloon letters, when you are dividing them in regards to idgham kamil and idgham naqis in case of noon sakina and tanween, whenever letter noon sakina and tanween are followed by letter meem, letter noon, letter lam, or letter ra, there is a complete merging. Noon sakina is completely merged into these letters. There is nothing left of the noon sakina. But when noon sakina or tanween are followed by letter waw or letter ya, one of the characteristic which is gunna of the sakin letter noon will left behind, and this is an incomplete merging or idgham naqis. There are some exceptions in the idgham of noon sakina. As we have already discussed, that the idgham of noon sakina does not happen in one word. And even if we have the conditions of idgham in one word, we do izhar. But there is one exception to this rule when it comes to one word in huruful muqatta'at, which is ta seen meem. If you try to open this word, you will write it like this, ta seen and meem. And now you can see the letter noon sakina is followed by letter meem, which is one of the letters of your maloon letters. So we will do idgham here. We will merge this letter noon sakina completely into meem. This will be idgham kamil, and we will recite it like this. The other exception is when reciting Surah Yaseen or Suratul Qalam, we will see these two verses. And if we choose to continue and do not stop at the end of this ayah in Surah Yaseen or in Suratul Qalam at this place, if we don't stop, we can see the conditions of idgham where noon sakina is followed by letter waw. But in case of Hafs and Asim, Tariqatul Shatibiyya, we recite these with idhar upon continuation, and we don't do idgham. We will recite them like this. Yaseen wal Qur'an al Hakim. In Suratul Qalam, if we choose not to stop here, we will recite it like this. Noon wal Qalami wa ma yasturun. Although we see the conditions of idgham, but in case of hafs, we recite them with idhar. Another exception is in Suratul Qiyamah, ayah number 27, we see the conditions of idgham, but in our way of hafs, we recite this ayah with sakt, a breathless pause, and we don't do idgham, although we see that noon sakina is followed by letter ra. So we will recite it like this. وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاقَ. Because there is a sakt, a breathless pause, both letters, letter ra or letter noon, are not meeting with each other. So there is no idgham. We will recite this letter noon with idhar. So these are the rules of idgham in noon sakina and tanween. Inshallah, we will continue with rest of the rules of Noon Sakina and Tanween. Jazakum Allah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.